I think it's only just backed up anyway. not gonna hook me up.
Stop talking.
Pop. Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Macarone and our high school band. Please rise for the, stay standing for the presentation of colors, please. Thank you very much for the color guard. You are relieved. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic. Thank you very much. The color guard is relieved. Thank you. Before we begin tonight, please, I ask you that you remain in your seats during the entire ceremony. Please do not relocate or stand and block the view of anyone that is already seated. Please remain silent during the ceremony so that we can hear the names of the students being called. And please silence your phones. And once again, good evening, buenas noches, Amityville Memorial High School, the class of 2022. You all look incredibly beautiful out there today. You made it? My apologies, you could sit down now, everybody else. We're not doing the Star Spangled Banner. Once again, good evening, buenas noches, Amityville Memorial High School, class of 2022. You finally made it. You should be proud of yourselves, and I know that I, for one, cannot be any prouder of you. I've known most of you since sixth grade, and I love all of the great human beings that you see here in front of us that you've grown into today. I'm blessed to have had the opportunity to serve you as your principal for the last 6 years. Before we begin, I'd like to thank our district office team, our Board of Education, our amazing teachers and guidance counselors, my team, Mr. Suckle, who has been your direct administrative supervisor for the past 3 years, Ms. Lim and Dr. Cardone, our outstanding security staff, our volunteer APTC, our outstanding custodians, the incredible secretarial staff, our amazing and supportive parents and guardians, and of course, you, the class of 2022, Amityville Memorial High School seniors. I want to thank you for your hard work, your perseverance, and your will to succeed during such a volatile and uncertain time in our history. You have all had an amazing journey to reach this destination. Some of you were born and bred right here in the Ville and went through all of the schools in Amityville to get to this point. Some of you came from other states, other towns, private schools, and many came from entirely different corners of the world. Regardless of the difficult journeys that so many of you have made to get here, we have among us today state champions, league champions, county champions, smart scholars, scholar athletes, and AP scholars. You've accumulated almost $3 million in scholarships this year. You are going to some of the best universities in the country. You are going into the military, and the list goes on and on and on. All of this was accomplished regardless of some of the most challenging paths imaginable. Our halls have been blessed with exceptional students who are kind, caring, compassionate, and who clearly persevere in the face of adversity. And although your journeys to get here today may have been different, you are here and you made it. No one expected your journey to unfold the way it did. During your first year here at the high school, we shut down on March 13th because of COVID-19. There were no goodbyes. Just like that, your year ended. Everything changed. You were introduced to new vocabulary words such as community spread, synchronous instruction, quarantines, exemptions, virtual learning, self-isolation, contact tracing, and essential workers. You learned that many of your parents and guardians were essential workers, and they were the real heroes of the time. Your junior year started with a torrential downpour from a nor'easter. You had your apps ready to check in. Your temperatures were supposed to be taken at home. You were wearing your masks. You learned newer words like super spreader, antibodies, herd immunity. It was what is now known, or what was known as the hybrid year. Your seasons were cut short. You wore masks every day. Some of you even chose to work from home all year long. Many of you mastered the art of what we called the ghost login, also known as logging in and getting back under your covers. You prepared for the Regents exams, which seemed normal. And then they were canceled, and the word exemption became part of the vernacular. And then comes your senior year. It also began with extreme uncertainty. We learned some new words again: variant strain, Omicron, booster, infusion. But as the year went on, it seemed normalcy was suddenly starting to return, or at least what has become normal. We had sports, assemblies, and about halfway through the year, you were finally able to eat at tables in the cafeteria. I think you'll agree that our schooly lunches began to taste even better and better. Check out the Instagram page. Masks became optional. You had a senior barbecue. You had an incredible senior prom. Thank you, Mr. Castro and everybody else. You had a great senior trip. And of course, you were finally allowed to take those Regents exams you're all waiting for. I know you're excited about those as well. You learned that things were getting back to normal, but then again, you learned there was a new normal. You also learned that 2 years after the murder of George Floyd, that this country still has a lot of work to do to fight racial injustice and systemic oppression of any kind. You saw what hatred could do to people in Buffalo, New York, where my own kids live and go to school, and Uvalde, Texas, where yet another senseless, avoidable, and unfathomable tragedy occurred. You saw the invasion of a sovereign and independent Ukraine by a superpower, and how the world stood behind Ukraine in its own fight against evil. You saw what was going on, and you spoke up, and you said that changes are necessary, and that you wanted to be part of those changes. Now, here you are, almost high school graduates. What changes do you want to see? What are you going to do to make those changes a reality? How are you going to work to change a system that is clearly not fair to everyone? These questions are not easy, but they are necessary ones, and I know that collectively you will find the answers to make the world a better place. I know that you will be agents of change. The late, great Shirley Chisholm once said so famously, "If they don't give you a seat at the table, then you better bring your own folding chair." You have all accomplished so much so far, and there are so many other opportunities ahead of you. As warriors, as Amityville warriors, you need to take full advantage of the opportunities ahead. You need to make your journey count. And you may need to bring your own chairs to the table sometimes. And don't let anyone ever tell you otherwise. Believe in yourselves, believe in your dreams, believe in the dreams of those you love and those closest to you and who have supported you. Listen to your parents and guardians. Believe it or not, there's a really good chance that actually they know more than you do. May your years ahead of you continue to be characterized by empathy, compassion, integrity, honor, kindness, and of course, your warrior pride. May your successes be many and your hardships be few, and I truly wish from the bottom of my heart that you get everything that you work hard for and that you deserve. If you want to accomplish something, you need to just do it. And never, ever make an excuse about why you can't. Be you. Be authentic. Be the authentic you every single day. You are Amityville warriors, and I know that you can do anything you set your minds to. In closing, I'm not going to leave you with a quote from a famous historian, musician, or activist. I'll share a little wisdom from some people who I've got to know over the last several years and who I admire and respect tremendously. Anulin Lama said, "Take advantage of opportunities. You'll never know where they may lead you." Brandon Dennis, "Don't be afraid to challenge yourselves." Scott Pineda, "When you think about your future, make sure that whatever you're doing right now will prepare you for it." Marcus Daniel Days, "Pride comes before a fall. Sometimes being put in your place will humble you." Dante Rigsby, "Just follow the right path." And then he added, "Always." Alexia Williams, "Be a leader, not a follower. And don't follow those that aren't doing the right thing." Misha Ankadovich, "Just do you. Oh, and don't forget to get some sleep." And finally, something from my awesome dad, a New York City firefighter, Army veteran, and all-around incredible human being. He recently said to me, "If someone has a personal problem with you, then that is their personal problem to have and not yours. If you always operate with integrity and never ever compromise your values, righteousness will prevail. You may not see that righteousness right away, but in the end, good will always conquer evil." To the class of 2022, thank you for allowing me to serve as your principal for all these years. I am proud and humbled to have get to know each and every one of you. We all know that love is the answer to a lot of the problems in this world. And I want you to know today that if no one yet told you that they loved you, I'm going to tell you right now. I love all you guys. Congratulations, class of 2022. It is now my pleasure to introduce the Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Edward Fell.
Thank you, Mr. Plyer. Mr. Plyer is a very tough act to follow. I think you know that. And his words were absolutely beautiful. So first and foremost, congratulations, class of 2022. So good evening, buenas noches to our parents, guardians who are here, members of the Board of Education, administrators, faculty, staff, and especially you, the soon-to-be graduates of Amityville Memorial High School. The traditions of this school, its history, and this school district and the school district's history are amazing. You are now a part of it. This graduation day signifies the hard work you have put into your studies, extracurricular activities, and sports in your past high school, the 4 years in high school. And it has been no easy feat. As Mr. Plyer mentioned, you've made it through the greatest struggles posed by the pandemic, and you returned full-time to school and adjusted, showing your abilities to adapt and overcome all types of adversity. It's truly a testament to your determination and your resilience. Throughout it all, you were guided by great teachers and school leaders, a great staff, along with a highly supportive Board of Education and community. Your parents and guardians have given you their care, and they will continue to do so even after you graduate. Here at Amityville Memorial High School, you had rich academic learning experiences, experience in the arts, programs in physical fitness, social and emotional skills, and a multitude of after-school clubs and athletics that compete with any school in the nation. You should feel confident knowing that you have been given all the ingredients for future success. So now, today is the day. This is the moment where your preparation meets opportunities ahead. Your education will be the vehicle that can bring you into a successful and enriching life. You may have heard, as we were talking about before, that your high school years were defined by troubling global experiences even now. But what I'd like to mention is that you are not defined by the obstacles or struggles you have faced. You are defined in the ways you persevered in spite of them. The optimism and happiness that you show, the kindness and love you lead with times when your peers, the kindness and love that you show in times with your peers and help that you give them when they are in need, and the vision you have for a better tomorrow. As you graduate from high school and move forward into college, the military, or the world of work, remember your preparation that you have been given here in Amityville. Remember those who have helped you. Think about those people who have helped you and try to emulate them. Appreciate your own talents. When you wake up each morning, look in the mirror and like who you see. Develop self-confidence. Develop the ability to make a difference, because each of you can touch the lives of others as people here have touched your life. Some advice I would like to offer, a few points, come from a book and a movie called Lessons from an Extraordinary Life. And they're simple, easy lessons. Everyone can learn more. Every experience that you have and every experience you have going forward is an opportunity to learn from. Every experience has meaning and value. Continue to learn. Become a lifelong learner. Maintain a positive attitude with a sense of hope and responsibility. Be confident of yourself. Be confident of your abilities. And what's really important, remember to have a sense of humor. Learn to laugh sometimes at your own actions or your own mistakes. Have in your mind to do all that you can do and be all that you can be. Set high goals for yourself. Learn to overcome obstacles. And when you set these high goals, don't let anyone discourage you. Don't give up and don't give in. That's probably one of the most important things to remember from today. Set the high goals and don't give up and don't give in. Stick to your goals and what you believe in and who you are. Don't let anyone distract or discourage you. When you make a mistake, learn from that mistake. That gives meaning to them. Every mistake you make has a meaning and helps you go forward more. The diversity of this class and of our world makes us stronger and strengthens us. During June, you celebrated Pride Month. Pride, while it has its origins in the LGBTQ+ community, is about respect for others. It's about all of us, a love for people, and appreciating the individual differences and diversity. With that in mind, I urge you to keep social justice in your minds and hearts. To paraphrase an American hero who passed away a little over a year ago, the great civil rights leader, John Lewis. John Lewis was a civil rights icon and a long-term congressman. And Mr. Lewis said, don't be afraid of getting in good trouble. Good trouble is necessary trouble to force the respect and for others to build a better society. What good trouble is something that means to speak up and speak out for positive change in our great American democracy. Never tolerate disrespect, don't tolerate injustice, become a change agent for a better world. So congratulations as you go forward. Good luck and Godspeed. Muchas felicidades, buena suerte.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fell. I'd like to welcome to the stage your salutatorian, Annie Lynn Llamas. Come on up. Andy Lynn will be studying nursing at Farmingdale State University.
Oh. Sorry, my sash is coming off. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of my fellow classmates, I firstly would like to say thank you to all the Board of Education members here tonight, especially President Dr. Terry Fulton, First Vice President Mr. Juan Leon, Second Vice President, Ms. Jeanette Santos, Trustee David Heller, Trustee Lisa Johnson, Trustee Leslie Kretz, and Trustee Carol Seehoff. Thank you to our central administration, Dr. Edward Fail, Dr. Joan Lang, Mr. Joseph Dragone, Dr. Bridget Waite, Mr. Peter Paternostro, Ms. Virginia Figueroa, Mr. Evan Farkas, Ms. Mary Stevens, and Dr. Fran Fernandez. Thank you to our high school administration, Mr. Playa, Mr. Suckle, Dr. Cardone, and Ms. Lim. And finally, thank you to our senior class advisor, Mr. Castro, our teachers, faculty members, staff, friends, and family that are all here today to support each and every one of our graduating seniors. We truly wouldn't be here without the guidance and support that you all have given us throughout our years here in Amityville. As this year's class salutatorian, I am deeply honored to be speaking in front of you all today. Although never would I have thought that being given the name of class salutatorian would entail writing and executing one last homework assignment that would be due the day of graduation. And like many of my assignments at first, I didn't know where to begin. And so I looked up examples of graduation speeches online, videos, and even asked friends and family and teachers for any piece of advice that they could give me to guide me through this speech. With all the guidance that I had received, I realized that I had to write a speech that came from the heart and write something that would encapsulate all the high and low points of our educational career so far. So, looking back on our years here in Amityville, our classes made a Harlem Shake video, danced to the High School Musical song, We're All in This Together, during our third grade moving up ceremony, slept through our online classes during quarantine, and more recently, we have gone to Six Flags, had our senior prom, and did our last walkthrough of our elementary and middle schools before we finally say goodbye to Amityville. I bring this up to show just how much we have gone through to get to this point, especially since I know that my fellow classmates aren't just students. My peers are student athletes, artists, musicians, and on top of that, they have other responsibilities such as extracurricular jobs, extracurricular clubs, jobs, and much more. These responsibilities come with such commitment and dedication. So being here today is a testament to show that everything we have done has paid off. However, today is not the end. It is just the beginning of the rest of our lives. Some of us may be going straight into the workforce, some will be going into the military, and others will be heading to college to further their education. No matter where each of us may end up, we will always carry the skills that we have learned throughout our years here in Amityville. Skills such as time management, advocating for yourselves, building relationships, and how to work a Google Meet are all essential to wherever we may go. On a personal note, some of you may or may not know, my family comes from the Philippines, a country that is made up of more than 7,000 islands and has a variety of cultural dishes. What it also has is the importance of education instilled in its people. Even though there are people in the Philippines who have little to no money for food or clothes, they will always find a way to scrape up some money to send their children to school, no matter what. And this key principle of education has always been encouraged in both myself and my brother growing up by my family. So I'd like to say thank you to my family and my parents who have always been there to support me in everything that I do. Whether that be in my award ceremonies, track meets, lacrosse games, and reminding me to always be humble and thankful in everything that I do. I'm not sure where my parents are right now, but I have a feeling my mom is crying and my dad is videoing this to post on Facebook, so shout out to them. With these morals that I've been raised with, I plan to continue my education within the field of nursing, a field where there's nonstop learning, whether that be understanding a patient's care plan, learning how to take vital signs, or understanding that being a nurse is not just about medical care. Rather, caring for these patients as if they were your own loved ones, in the sense that you will do anything to make them feel more comfortable. With this, I encourage you all to keep learning and stay curious. Yet learning does not have to be your basic school subjects. It can also be about learning new cultures by traveling, or learning a new recipe to show all your friends. Even within our own class, there are numerous cultures and backgrounds that we can always learn more about. The famous influential speaker Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. There's a whole world outside of Amityville that we haven't discovered yet. I hope that you all get a chance to go out and explore the world around you. And always remember that once a warrior, always a warrior. Congratulations to the class of 2022, and good luck on your future journeys."
Thank you, Andy Lynn. Please welcome to the stage your valedictorian of the class of 2022, Misha Ankadovich. Misha will be attending Northeastern University in Boston, studying data science and economics.
All right. Like Mr. Ply always says, it's a great day to be alive here in the Ville. Good evening, once again, and thank you all for coming to celebrate the commencement of the class of 2022 of Amityville Memorial High School. I speak for the entire class when I extend another warm welcome and thank you to the high school administration, Mr. Suckle and Dr. Cardone, who have seen us mature through the last 3 years, and a special thank you to Mr. Playa and Ms. Lim, who have seen us grow from seventh graders into graduating seniors. Additionally, I would like to thank the members of the central administration team, Dr. Fail, Dr. Lang, Mr. Dragone, Dr. Waite, Mr. Paternostro, Mrs. Figueroa, Mr. Farkas, Ms. Stevens, for always supporting and facilitating our learning behind the scenes, as well as the Amityville Board of Education, President Dr. Fulton, First Vice President Mr. Leon, Second Vice President Ms. Santos, and trustees Mr. Heller, Ms. Johnson, Ms. Kretz, and Mrs. Seehoff. Thank you for helping to make the decisions that have allowed us all to reach this point. Alongside our amazing and dedicated teachers, these professionals have remained dedicated to our academic and social-emotional growth. Our progress has been a fruit of their labor, and there is not enough words to describe our gratitude. Additionally, I'd be remiss if I did not mention and thank all the people who have supported me personally. First and foremost, my amazing family, some of whom are from Amityville, others from across the country, and even across the world from Ukraine, who have all continually shown support and love for me and through all of our years of high school, and they are here supporting me today. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Mizraki and Ms. Keenan, wherever they went, for helping me to write this speech, and the wonderful Mrs. Sherry for sticking with our French class. The truth is that every single teacher, staff, and every other person in this building and district has had a profound impact on the person that I and all of we have become, and it would be impossible to name every single one of them. But once again, thank you all. Graduating from high school is a huge accomplishment that is constantly overlooked or taken for granted, especially in recent years as the challenges that we have had to face have been multifaceted and intense. Our generation has been on the forefront of national and international pivotal societal change. We have witnessed the entire world alter itself to adapt to the COVID-19 pandemic, which I'm sure we're all too really tired of hearing about at this point. The world shifted to a halt as we changed from in-person to online learning and then eventually back to a so-called semi-normal senior year. We've also witnessed firsthand the worsening of a climate crisis that realistically could put our very town underwater, as well as a gun violence issue that puts children in schools all across the country at risk. In saying this, I don't mean to sound pessimistic or dejectful. Rather, I want to remind everyone that it is now up to us. It is our turn to incite change in the world. It is our turn to stand up in honor of the young children in Uvalde who will never see a high school graduation. It is our turn to lead in honor of my friends, family, and others currently suffering in Ukraine. And it is our turn to unite the world in honor of George Floyd, Breonna Taylor, and the countless others who have tragically lost their lives too early due to racism, bigotry, and misunderstanding. It is our turn to change the world, and I have no doubt that together we will. Some of us are starting our journey by attending a 2-year or a 4-year college program. Others are making the sacrifice by joining the armed forces, and others are heading directly into the workforce. Regardless of what we decide to do for our post-high school plans, if I learned anything over the past 4 years is that each one of us will be equally active and important in changing the world for the better. We've also faced a significant number of changes right here at home as well. We were the first group of students to test out block scheduling, the first to explore the completed new buildings, and the first in a while to experience sharing said building with the ninth graders. Yikes. We've also been the first senior class in 2 years to go on a senior trip, have a seemingly normal prom, and other senior events. We've been given the opportunity to rewrite the playbook, and we have done so. And the truth is, I don't think we'll ever stop. In my time here, I spent a lot of time getting to know all of you. I also spent a lot getting to know people from other schools. While everyone has a lot to say about Amityville, I truly believe that all of us make up an astounding and upstanding community. When I started speaking, I thanked members of the school community for helping us reach this point. But the truth is, I've got one very important acknowledgement, all of you. We may not speak the same language, we may not have the same backgrounds, and we may not be going to the same places, but this school community has had an extremely and profound impact on the person that I've become and the person that I plan to be. So thank you all for that and for letting me speak tonight. And one last time, let's go Warriors.
Thank you very much, Misha. Our president of the Board of Education, Dr. Fulton, would like to say a few words.
Good evening. Class of 2022, give yourself a hand. Class of 2022. Yes. You have finished your journey here. You have triumphed to this day here where you come to graduate, walk on the stage. Some of you started your journey at Northeast. Some started the journey at Northwest. And some came along down the road here. But regardless where you started, you have come here today to graduate. And you all should be extremely proud of yourselves. Your parents are here. Your guardians are here. Friends and family to see this special day. Many told you that you wouldn't make it to this day. But you looked them in the eyes and said, "Watch me. On this day, I will graduate." Oh, it's a wonderful, wonderful day. I just want to encourage you, as you leave today, some would go over to higher education, some will immediately go into the workforce, and some will take up a trade. And yes, there will be some days where things will be difficult. There will be some days where you get knocked down, but don't give up. Remember, you are a warrior. Remember, you have been tested. Remember, you have went through the fire, and you have come up successful. You have graduated today. Martin Luther King says that we all become part of the problem when we become silenced on injustice. Many of us turn our back when we see injustice because it's not affecting them. But maybe not today, but what about tomorrow? You are the changes, class 2022, that the world is looking for. Everybody is saying, what is the change? What is the change? Where is the change? You are the change. Why can't you be the change that this world needs, that this world seeks? Be strong. Be determined. Be perseverance and make a change. God bless you.
Thank you very much for those words, Dr. Fulton. I'd like to welcome to the stage, it's going to be hard to top that one, but Mr. Castro, come on up, your senior class advisor.
Good evening, senior class of 2022. Thank you for the administrative team at the high school, Mr. Playa, Mr. Suckle, Dr. Cardone, and Ms. Lim. Thank you to our board, and thank you to our district leadership, Dr. Lang, Dr. Fail, Dr. Fulton, Dr. Waite, and Dr. Dragone, for being here today. Last but certainly not least, thank you to your wonderful families for being out today. I've had the pleasure to teach in Amityville for the last 6 years. And when I was asked to be this senior class advisor, I could tell how important the opportunity was by the overwhelming number of faculty and staff who offer their support all year. It's a testament to how great this senior class is. On everyone's mind was all that this graduating class had been through. They spent half their sophomore year under COVID lockdown, and their junior year was mostly canceled because of the numerous spikes in COVID-19. It seemed that their senior year was in trouble. But this was a building united in giving the class of 2022 the senior experience they deserved. I was happy to take on the role, and I feel blessed to have shared this year with you all. We would not have had a successful year, however, if not for the APTC and our senior officers, Renee, our treasurer, Jack, our secretary, Marilyn, our vice president, and Misha, our class president. We put together a great senior experience that they should be very proud of. I'm not sure if they're going to miss my morning messages or my increasing stress level, but I hope that their tenure as senior class officers has taught them how to collaborate as a team and take on leadership roles. I know that they will go on to do great things. Before I introduce your class president again, I'd like to advise you as a graduating class one last time. For any student who has known me, my main catchphrase is peace and love. Whenever I see students acting foolish and, well, being high school students, I say, hey, peace and love. It's often the only thing I need to say or do for you to stop whatever it is you're doing. You know exactly what I mean when I say it, and I say it to remind you of what actions make a fulfilling life. The writer Mark Twain once said, if you tell the truth, you don't have to remember anything. The same is true with my catchphrase. If you take peace and love with you into any situation or conflict, even if you make mistakes or fail, you'll be sure that your actions came from the right place. So I'll modify Mark Twain's quote to say, if you live your life with peace and love, you'll never regret anything. I wish the very best for you, and I hope you enjoy this special day. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Now, before I leave, we do have a drone, so I would love to take a selfie. So if you could look up, wave to our drone, piloted by Mr. Cimino. Okay, get a couple good shots. Okay. All right. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming your class president to the stage, Misha Ankudovich.
All right, I'm gonna make this one quick. Good evening once again, and thank you to the high school administration, the central administration, and the Board of Education once again for always supporting the class of 2022 in our endeavors. Most importantly, I would like to thank all of our teachers and other crowd members who are here to witness and to celebrate the amazing achievements of the class of 2022. We've had a lot of advisors. We've had Mr. Lettieri, Mrs. Morales, Mrs. Howard, Mrs. Shulkin, Mrs. Mizrahi, Mr. Suckel, Ms. Schweigert, and our current amazing senior class advisor, Mr. Castro. Thank you to all of them for being either our official or our unofficial advisors over the past few years. This is it. We did it. And I kept thinking that to myself, you know, a day ago, a week ago, an hour ago, but this is finally it. I'm so proud of every single one of us for making it to this point. Some of us have spent over a decade of our lives walking through the halls of these schools, and some of us have spent significantly less time here. But regardless, reaching this finish line is an amazing accomplishment that we should all be proud of. In our ninth grade year, we governed over the halls of the middle school as we prepared for our first homecoming parade and our ninth grade dance. Everything felt completely normal, and it was. In our 10th grade year, we had finally made it to the high school, and again, everything had a sense of normalcy. We had fundraised, and we went to homecoming, and for 7 months, everything made sense, until it all ended. The world plunged into a pandemic, and we did all we could to try to stay on top of it. In our 11th grade year, we switched our classrooms into Google Meets from our bedrooms, and the cafeteria was exchanged for Uber Eats, and it still has been. We held virtual meetings while being vaccinated, and we genuinely had no idea what the years ahead would hold. Then came our senior year, and we made the absolute most of it. With a regular senior trip and a prom, I can absolutely say that we did it. We made it through every hurdle and every challenge. We made it. We made it through years that will be written about in the history books. With our soccer team going to states, our marching band playing in New York City, people in track going to nationals, and a win from our baseball team, Amityville is as strong as ever, and that is because of each and every one of us. In the last few weeks, I'm sure everyone has been told that we are now prepared to live in the real world. But to them, I say we've already been living in it. We've endured and prospered through a global pandemic, stood up against injustices both at home and around the globe, and always refused to be quiet. In one way or another, each one of us has become a leader. If this isn't the real world, then what is? So no, we aren't magically transitioning into a new, real world. The only difference is now the world will be in our hands. It will be our ability and our responsibility to mold it into a better place for every single person, and I know we will. I have no doubt that everybody in front of me will grow and achieve astounding things in whatever they set their minds to. And I know this because I've witnessed us grow from kids who couldn't tie their shoes into upstanding young adults who are strong as individuals and stronger in numbers. We are the class of 2022, a class who has been through it all, and a class who is ready and willing to lead the world. Thank you all for allowing me to serve as your class president and for making Amityville the amazing place that it is. And for one final time, I wish all the graduates a congratulations and the best of luck. Let's go take the real world by storm.
Thank you very much, Misha. Before we get to the moment you've all been waiting for, I'd like to recognize all current or retired members of the United States military. Could you please stand up so we can recognize you? I'd also like to recognize our students who have decided to enter the military after they graduate high school. Please rise when I call your name. David Fuentes, Matthew Magnan, Tristan McLeod, and Marilyn Ortiz, please stand up. David and Matthew will be serving in the United States Marine Corps, Tristan will be serving the United States Army, and Marilyn will be joining the Army Reserve. Good luck to you all, and thank you for your willingness to sacrifice it all. And at this time, we're going to present the diplomas. I'm going to miss you guys. I am going to miss you guys so much. But let's get this started. Mr. Castro, students, when you hear your name, you know what to do. You're going to come up that side and go that way. Are you ready, Mr. Castro? I love you too, man. I love you. Let's do this. Students, when your name is called, bring your card to Mr. Castro.
Misha Ankadovich. Andalyn Yamas. Aj Abru Duran. Eric Acosta. Jadik Atkin. Carolina Alcantara. Kyle Alosia. Justin Almanzar. Diana Alvarez. Yaneli Amaya. Jalen Amaya Gomez. Luis Amaya Sanchez.
She's in the middle. She's good.
Jacqueline Andino. Jada Andrews. William Ortega Amaya. Christopher Avila Valencia. Kevin Aviles Martinez. Juan Amaya Guevara. Gabriela Ayala Martinez. Stephanie Barrera Prudicino. Michelle Barrera Cruz. Danielle Barrios. Nivia Benoit. Shade Benimon. Tyjon Billinger. Olivier Boulevard. Seema Bomar. Aliyah Bonaparte. Sanaya Bryant. Johnny Kelly Koba. Elijah Kennedy. Denny Canales Venatoro. Brian Candia Flores. Anderson Capellan. Mariana Castro Carvajal. Liz Mary Cerdo Paratala. Bryce Sherry. Amar Chambers. Anthony Clark. Mark Koba. Melissa Contreras. Silas Contreras. Stephanie Contreras Gomez. Shaheem Cruz. Jeff Cruz. Marcus Daniels Days. Jaden Davis. Michael De La O Silva. Brandon Dennis. Marieri Durante Rodriguez. Alexa Echevera Chavez. Harley Ellie. Cassidy Facey. Ulrich Ferrier. Brandon Fernandez. Liliana Fernandez Rodriguez. Joshua Figs Stallings. Kayla Fisher. Timothy Fontaine. Leah Friedland. David Fuentes. Kimberly Funes. Nadalyn Gomez Martinez.
Yeah, Nate.
Alexia Gordon.
Yeah, Alexia. Yeah, like.
Rebecca Gray.
Yes.
Jaden Griffin.
Malik.
Malik Griffin.
Yes.
Pablo Guevara. Kiara Guzman. Yancy Guevara Santos. Ayana Haddad. Alex Hargrove. Jermaine Hatcher Jr. Lance Headley. Jean-Marie Henry. Catherine Hernandez. Kenya Hernandez. Kevin Hernandez. Aria Hibbert. Janet Ho. Being presented by board member Jeanette Santos. Jermaine Hilton. Jason Izaguirre Rivera. Jonathan Jackis. Zaire Jackson. Randy Jerez. Marie Gianard. Jerron Johnson.
Don't flirt.
Brian Gerardo Pineda. Abdullah Khan. Sarah Ledesky. Isaiah Liberato. Sensasia Little. Brianna Locke. Anaya Thomas. Anne Lauren Keel. Mia Bradley. Emily Longforsey. Brianna Loss. Yevinson Lewis.
Yeah, big song!
Shy Lucas III.
Yes, sir! What is this song about?
Jamal Luciano. Matthew Megan.
Mari Duenya.
Daniel Mari Duenya. Davies Martinez Hernandez. Soraya Mathis Foski. Gianelli McCaddy. Anaya McLeod Griffin. Tristan McLeod. Fatima Mendez Oliva. Savion Mills. Kiri Mejia Santos.
Oh Lord.
Sanai Muhammad.
Yes, Sanai.
Samantha Molina. Hugo Morales. Brian Morales Madrid. Randall Morenci. Joanne Morris. Imani Miles. Natalia Nunez.
You wanna get that? I got you.
Akinwale Ori Shajimi. Marilyn Sanchez Ortiz. Randy Ortiz Garcia. Jordy Ortiz Guian. Rutilio Pacheco. Stephanie Pajero. Ruby Perez. Maurice Petway Jr. Scott Pineda. Jonathan Pintos Claros. Juan Ponce.
J17, y'all know what it is.
Kamar Porsche. Jamie Ramirez. Amanda Ramos. Allison Ramos Lopez. Nathaniel Regis. Erica Quinty Best. Kyle Remy. David Reyes.
Dion Blaz, you know that.
Francisco Reyes Ortiz.
Thank you so much for everything.
Dante Risby. Randy Rodriguez. Zachary Rodriguez. Ricardo Ruiz Aliman.
Yes, sir!
Rachel Sabatelli. Emmanuel Salazar. Denixon Sibin Sanabria. Anaya Santiago. Renee Santos. Ruben Saravia. Steve Saravia. Carrick Sadahu. Justin Sattar. Lily Scott. Nancy Segovia Mejia. Michaela Seiferhood. Larenson Supervita. Jack Sicoli. Daniel DJ Sinclair. Savion Smith.
Mr. XD!
Jeffrey Sordo Zavilla. Makai Stevenson. Jadalyn Stewart. Elijah Todd. Stephanie Urbina. Brianna Vargas. Annie Velasquez Gonzalez. Brian Velasquez Santos. Cesar Villalobos. Fernando Villalobos Rivera. Tycon White. Alexia Williams. Olivia Wright. Shane Wright.
Today class is still me. Hell yeah.
Odin Wright Fox. David Zambrano. Catherine Zuniga. Leonella Ijaskas Jaramillo. Hamiro. Sorry.
Thank you, Mr. Castro. Thank you, the class of 2022. At this time, as high school principal, I can now certify to our superintendent of schools, Dr. Edward Fell, that the students who are about to be presented to you and the Board of Education have satisfied the graduation requirements of the State Education Department and Board of Education, and therefore are eligible to receive an Amityville Memorial High School Diploma from the Amityville Union Free School District Board of Education. Ladies and gentlemen, I am honored and pleased to present to you Amityville Memorial High School Class of 2022. Please move your tassel from right to left. You are now the alumni of Amityville Memorial High School. Congratulations. Don't be strangers. Come back and visit. Ms. Macaron, how about one last song for us, Ms. Macaron, before you retire?
Ms. Carol, Ms. Amy, I love y'all. Brooke, I love y'all. All my fans and supporters, I love y'all.